Hi, welcome back to my channel and I'm Dr. Neha and today we will discuss about green chemistry principle number 8. Up till now we have covered 7 principles and now today we'll discuss 8. The 8th principle says reduce derivatives. Reduce derivatives means what they say as per the principle, it is unnecessary derivatization should be minimized or avoided if possible. Because such steps require additional reagents and can generate waste. So basically what they say that if at all is possible, don't increase the number of steps. Because that is what is called as derivatization. Means let's say you have to use raw material A and you have to take your product C. But what are you doing is you are converting A to B. And then you are using B to convert it into C. This practice is not as per the principle number 8. Principle 8 says that you directly try to convert A to C. This B making in between byproduct is unnecessary derivatization. Right? You make derivatives of A to change to B, then B to C. So normally we do it, if you remember, while using blocking groups or protection or deprotection. I hope you remember, in case of benzene electrophilic substitution reactions, we normally have ortho or meta and para directing groups, right? Ortho directing groups, para directing groups, meta directing groups. So that time what we do is we protect the place if it is a meta directing group, and then we do the reaction and then we deprotect the particular position, right? And we use a blocking group also sometimes, so that should be avoided. Or temporary modification of physical or chemical process, so sometimes we do that. So as per principle number 8, they say, why don't you find out a process wherein number of steps are less? Try to find out that within minimum number of steps, if you are able to make something, that is what principle number 8 says. Because when you increase the derivatives, means you increase the steps, it will involve additional reagents. Obviously, higher cost of the product, it will generate more waste and more time. So basically, one step is going to affect so many parameters, and they say that you reduce the steps. So reduce the derivatives if at all is possible. Let's say one case study is of ibuprofen. This I have discussed in my previous videos also. When I showed you the atom economy, I told you that here ibuprofen, earlier the boot company 1960s, they were making ibuprofen using 6-step synthesis. Later on, it was substituted by Celanese Corporation, HC, and then resulting in BHC Venture, and then they reduced step to 3. So earlier, step 6 were required to prepare the same compound, and now the same compound could be prepared using step 3. Definitely, you can make that here the derivatives are reduced. Since the steps are reduced, the reagents, additional reagents which are required are reduced, time is saved, money is saved, and like that. So first case study is this. Let us go ahead to our daily lives. In fact, what we do is we do copy and paste, you know, control C and control V sometimes when we need something. Let's take an example of a chemical structure. Now you all know that drawing a chemical structure takes a lot of effort, time, right? Let's say our process right now is to take that particular structure, draw this particular structure. Now if you use certain softwares like CAM Office Plus or Cloud, you can reduce that derivative, you can reduce that steps involved in it. Because if you don't use cloud and if you don't save a particular work of yours on the cloud or CAM Office, again you have to draw from the scratch if you don't have a base copy of it, right? So every time, if it is not copied to the clipboard, if it is not there on the cloud, you have to again use the software, let's say ChemDraw, to, you know, make it altogether new. So that is how cloud or CAM Office or these kind of softwares are a classic example of, you can say, principle number 8, with the help of which we can anytime start our process from any step. Right? And then from there we can take it out and we can modify and utilize it. So this saves our time, this saves the overall cost of the process to be made and like that. So I think this is a quite an interesting example, you won't find anywhere. Next, last one more example is penicillin derivatives. Synthetically, when you prepare, it is a multi-step synthesis and there are lot many number of steps due to derivatization. But when you go for a green approach, we use the enzyme there, and due to which derivatization step is eliminated and obviously better yields are obtained. So in a nutshell, additional steps in a reaction generate lot of waste and reduce the efficiency. So I think with that you are able to understand that this principle number 8 focus on reducing the derivatives or reducing the number of steps involved in making a particular product. That's all for today. If you have liked it, please hit on like, that will give me motivation. And if you are new to my channel, please do subscribe. Thank you so much.